This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the metric system of measurement. I want to start out by comparing the way we measure distance in America with the way the metric system would do it. So in America, we have a number of different units that we use for measuring distance. For a fairly small distance, we have an inch. And then if we want something bigger, we go to the foot. So a foot is 12 inches. If we want something bigger than that, we have a yard. A yard is 3 feet. Or we could convert that into inches. That would be 36 inches. And then, of course, we have the mile. And a mile is 5,280 feet. Now, the system gets kind of clumsy. You have to memorize all these different conversions. And then the conversion numbers that we're using, like 5,280, are not really convenient. So if you want to know like how many feet there are in 3 miles, you're multiplying 3 times 5,280. The metric system is a whole lot easier. In the metric system, instead of having different units of measure, there's really only one unit when we're talking about distance. The basic unit of measure is the meter. A meter is about 39 inches long. That's not exact, but it's approximate. Or about the length of a baseball bat. If you want something bigger than a meter, you can go to the kilometer. So what we're doing is we're taking a prefix, kilo, which means 1,000, and we're just putting it in front of that basic unit, the meter. And the kilometer is 1,000 meters. So if you have something which is 7 kilometers and you want to convert it into meters, you just multiply 7 times 1,000. A kilometer is about 3/5 of a mile. If you have a 5-kilometer race, that would be a 3-mile race, approximately. Now we can have units smaller than the meter. We can have a prefix centi, which means 1/100th, and a centimeter is going to be 1/100th. I'll write that as a decimal. 1/100th of a meter. And once again, it would be fairly easy to convert. If we had 5 meters and we wanted to convert it to centimeters, we would just multiply that 5 times 100 to find out how many hundredths there were, and that'd be 500 centimeters. Smaller than a centimeter is a millimeter. A millimeter is 1/1000th of a meter. And just for reference, something like a CD or a DVD is about 1 millimeter thick. Okay, so this is the basics for how we do measurement of distance in the metric system. We can also measure volume and weight. And there are a couple other prefixes that we could use, but probably won't. So here's the whole system. The whole system works like this. There are actually 6 different prefixes. The most popular ones are the ones I mentioned, kilo, centa, and milla. There are also prefixes for 100 times. So hecto, something like a hectometer, is 100 meters, and deca, a decameter, meter is 10 meters, and also deci, which is 1/10. So a decimeter is 1/10 of a meter. But again, those 3 prefixes, hecto, deca, and deci, are not used very often. So the ones you're going to see are going to be kilo, as in kilometer, centi, and milla. Now, besides measuring distance, we could measure volume. So whereas in America, when we measure volume, we talk about pints and ounces and quarts and gallons, in the metric system, there's only one basic unit, the liter. A liter is approximately the size of a quart. You've seen 2-liter bottles of soda, and they have about 2 quarts of soda in them. If we have a lot of liquid or a large volume, then we have a kiloliter, which is 1,000 liters. If we have a small volume, we have a centiliter, that's 1/100th of a liter, and even smaller than that is a milliliter, or 1/1,000th of a liter. And then we have another basic unit for weight. This is the gram, just as in America we have ounces and pounds and tons and so on. So a gram is very light. A gram is about the weight of a dollar bill or a small paperclip. If you have a kilogram, that's 1,000 grams, and that's about 2.2 pounds. If you have something that's lighter than a gram, you might have a centigram, that's 1/100th of a gram, or much lighter than that would be a milligram, that's 1/1,000th of a gram. A lot of times you'll see milligram used when people talk about medicine. Okay, so this is basically the way the metric system works. You've got three basic units of measure, one for distance, the meter, one for volume, the liter, and one unit for weight, the gram. And then you've got a system of prefixes. The most important ones are kilo, centa, and milla, that you use when you want to change the size of that basic meter. Okay, so that's how the system works. I hope this helped. Take care. I'll see you next time.